All right, the number one thing that I've always seen go wrong with these residential style air conditioners is what they call the dual capacitor, which is right here. Pretty simple to diagnose and change. First thing I'm going to want to do is I'm going to want to turn the power off by the disconnect switch, or you can turn the power off at the breaker inside. So let's go ahead and do that. Alright. So I've taken the disconnect out. Goes in there, that way I stop the voltage going to the condensing unit. Now this is an Amana condenser. This capacitor right here is a CAP050-0350440CS. So, not sure what the MFD rating is, but let's go ahead and we'll pull that out here in a second and I'll show you how to test it. Most common problem for air conditioning or heat pump failures that I've seen on all different brands. Okay, so this capacitor right here has two screws that are holding it in. I'll take those out. This one's actually kind of tucked up there pretty tight. So with those screws off, that's why you got to make sure the power's out so you don't shock yourself. Even once you get this out, I don't know if you can see that. Something's holding it in. Oh, there we go. So I left the bracket on. Got a stink bug on there. Alright, so pro tip here is we've got to short these together. We only do this once we know the power is off. So you just take, you can take a screwdriver or something and you just touch them together. Let's see, touch them together, and if it's got stored energy, it'll have discharged. So I just touch them together, and that'll prevent me from getting shocked taking these off. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to mark these kind of crudely, just for simplicity. So I'm going to take my marker and I'm going to mark them. So. Kind of hard to do with one hand. So, let's see if I can do this. And I'm just going to go like one, and then I'll mark the wires one, two, and then I'll mark that wire with two little marks. This one with three. And then that way, I don't even have to read the wiring diagram. I'm just going to put them back where I found them. All right, next step is, since I've marked them, one, two, three, just take the wires off. I can pull them off like that. And then we're going to, if you got an electrical meter, you want to put it on reading capacitance. That's going to be right there, and this one's rated 35.5, which means between common and herm I should read 35, and between common and fan I should read 5. So Let's see what we read. So, common to Herm, 35. Common to fan, 5. So this capacitor is good, but if it was reading, and it'll usually tell you right on here what the range is. Usually they're like 6%, plus or minus 6%. This one doesn't actually say it on there, but that's kind of what we go by. So once again, C to Herm. My meter's reading 35. C to fan, 3 and 5. So this is good, but I want to check that obviously before summer. That way I can make sure it's good to go. So there is 4, 25, 21, and I checked it. But typically if it's out of range, it's going to keep your fan or your compressor from running. You can go on Amazon and you can find these, or any online supply houses. And that's like the number one thing that I've seen. Typically, you know, contractors are going to charge you for, you know, a service call anywhere from probably $150 to $400 to change that out. Number one thing I seen when I was a contractor, and I would buy these by the 50s because they were so common to go out. So if your heat pump or air conditioner stops working, I don't care what brand it is, if you've got a meter, or if you go in there and you see this thing kind of mushroomed up and it's real rusty, and yours is your air conditioner or heat pump has stopped working, chances are it's this. This would be the number one thing I check first. And then the second thing would be a contactor. So I'm going to go ahead and put this back in, and I hope this video helped you troubleshoot or diagnose your system. Leave me some feedback in the comments if you thought this thing was good, and consider hitting the thumbs up button, because that helps YouTube share my content. I really appreciate it, and thanks for stopping by.